Okay. How's it going, everybody? It's the CDH Warrior coming at you with the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. So, the other day we were looking at locked mementos. So now we're going to go visit Impa and get more information. Okay. Let's see, can I land on the steps? Yes! Alright, Impa, I'm back. And that orb back there is actually part of a shrine quest. I heard Poro was giving you the runaround, but you seem just fine. Now we have the camera function.
Oh.
The camera that Princess Zelda used 100 years ago. It could be that if you visit the locations within those pictures, you will be able to restore some of your lost memories. Give me 1 second. Okay. There's something I wish to give to you. Okay. We get to find out later. Captured memories, but we don't have side shrine quests yet. Well, now that we've got that done, okay, and this is the fairy fountain. We will need to visit this thing later. But for right now, I don't want to visit it. Just to cloud up the stream. This is the search for the fairy fountain. He's trying to find the exact location, but that's not easy to find. Now this is a main quest. Oh. As I just keep running into it. We have a horse now, so we do and don't need to worry too much about having extra stamina. So our next issues will be trying to get heart containers. We'll get heart containers from the Divine Beast, but that doesn't help us. Okay. And I'll show you where the shrine is. Where this fountain is. It's up here, I believe. Oh, a rabbit! Really? It's gone. I didn't intend to do that. Okay, here's the old man. So it's not around this direction. Here's the fountain. Let's examine it. Of course. There are three of these, I think. Okay. I don't have the 100 rupees. Oh, let's not use the torch to attack. If we break the torch, we'll have problems later. So, let's go through the map. There's Hateno Village. There's Bashkala Shrine. This is where I'm trying to discern what to do for this week. Because I really don't just want to leave you all running around, but it's not easy to do this. And we used a lot of our materials trying to help Robbie. So, right now we're going to try and deal with Kakariko Village. Going south. We really don't want to go south. So did we really just get attacked by a goat? Okay, come on, goat. And it disappeared. Wow. But we're back to the horses. What we're gonna try and do is we're gonna try and find some more of the towers. And mark them on our map. Hey Mikey, how are you doing? Let's see. I Can we get up there? Yes, we can. So from this vantage point, we're going to try and find some of the towers. I know it looks weird that we're just marking these things what appears to be at random. Okay, that's looking back towards the castle. It's raining so much I can't do that. Do anything. That's Eldon that we can see in the distance. Hang on. That should be the tower for Eldon. And then... there's another tower. So, what we've got right now, there's one tower, here's another, there's a tower here. Change to stamp. So I'm gonna stamp it as a star. No. No, we're going to leave it as a pin. As we just go sliding down the hill. So, we're going to try and find the fairy fountain. We're going to try and get... we found the fairy fountain. We just need to... pay the fairy fountain. Which is a lot easier said than done. This is the clothing shop. Let's see. There should be a shop. That's the inn. Let's try this one. This is the one with all the fruits. Let's try and sell some of the stuff we collected earlier. selling opal and selling amber isn't really worth anything. However, we are going to sell all these bokoblin horns. We can get more of them anyway. They're dropped with every bokoblin kill. Let's sell two of these. Tree branch. Wow. I was kind of hoping it was something more impressive. Okay, so we're walking around with the chicken now. Here's the fountain. Not in this direction. Should be. Oh. And these are silent shrooms. They'll help increase your stealth. And we're back at the fountain. Here's our 100 rupees. Now we get the obligatory opening of the flower. And the fairy fountains are common. I'm trying to remember where they are in Skyward Sword. They're also in Link's Awakening. Of course, they're not this extreme or extravagant. Okay. Okay. What? This opened the fountain. I really have nothing to enhance.
Aww.
Now, we will visit her again later. But that finished. Find the fairy fountain. One last thing. That gets us the fairy fountain picture. Finishes that quest up. Wow. I thought it'd be more sacred and elegant. There's a big mountain east of this village. It's Lanayru. Ultimately, that's where our next goal will be. It's the Nadra Snowfield. There's a dragon there, and we need to have the scale of it for one of the shrine quests. So, that quest is complete. Next quest. So, our next goal... is freeing the divine beasts, and we're going to start out this goal by heading this direction. Oh, that's a sheer cliff. We're not going that direction. We are going that direction, but we're not. So what we're going to wind up having to do is we're going to teleport out of here. So that's Elden. This is Lanayru. This is Gerudo. And this is Rito. The Rito area. Do not ask me why they named these regions so strangely. I have no clue. I'm playing Skyward Sword on Fridays, and I've been playing through it, and I won't spoil it for most people, but it's a shock to know what happened to some of these areas. Okay. So which area do we want to go to? We're going to go try and go this direction first. So this is going to be our best option. Okay. I was not expecting something to just show up in the out of the blue like that. But let's do this shrine. Since we've warped here, we might as well do the shrine while we're at it. Oh, this is the wind. This is one of my favorite shrines out of the game. Of course, in some cases, it can also be the most frustrating. We're gonna get this fossilized amber. Now, here's where the shrine really starts to get aggravated. Because oh, definitely don't want to go back across like that. So there's our goal right there. What we're going to have to do there's a chest here in front of us. And there is a switch somewhere. Where is this one? No, there's not a switch. I thought I had enough speed to get that. Well, that's game over. We'll start again from this shrine. Okay. So we know the first part. So there's the first wind. Now, into the middle of the room. So we're going this way. At the top, turn left. No. The stupid thing is, that's actually right. Sorry, somebody wrote a walkthrough for this shrine and I'm reading it and laughing at it. Thank you. Okay, turn right. When you land and jump the ledge on the middle of the platform. Okay, so the chest that we see here is a soldier's claymore. That would be worth getting. Oh, I know what I'm doing. So I'm accidentally moving out of the air current. So now we're to here. You know what? We'll just deal with the monk. Because that's the easy part. The weapon is a claymore. We'll try and come back for it a different time. It's not worth it because there are hundreds of them. Now we have our spirit orb. May the goddess smile upon you. Okay. So now with that shrine out of the way, I really don't want to deal with the moblin, but... we'll try and get another weapon. Oh, I was kind of hoping I would just take the... yeah. The coblins. That was a mistake. I was going to take the bokoblin's rake, and that didn't work. Okay. Let's take... the broadsword. So that gets rid of all of those. Are we really attacking people with farming tools? Okay. Let's see if we can avoid this moblin. He didn't see us. Okay. So over in here is the road. And that's a Pharaoh. That's Pharosh. We'll later need a Pharosh scale. And that's how you get them. Is you have to fire an arrow directly at it. It is 6:30 in the morning, according to the game. So that would be about right for Pharosh to show up. Please don't disappear on me. It's one, if we miss the Pharaoh scale, it's not necessarily the end of the world. This is the Bridge of Hylia. Okay. Okay. One Pharaoh scale. That was lucky we got it on the first try. So, I'll explain why we need a Pharaoh scale. Later on, we'll have a shrine that we need the Pharaoh scale for. Please ignore my insanity. I pressed the wrong button. Lizzle spear. Oh. Well, so be it. I don't really care about this. I'm just trying to see if I can knock him off the ledge. There we go. There's a Zora spear. So now we're going to take the Zora spear and use it. Now, there's the Ferro Scale. I wanted to make sure we picked that up because we won't see him for another couple of weeks. And that's if we're lucky. But to end our stream, we're going to get to this tower over here. We are on our way south. So here's the tower. So ultimately, our goal is just to try and get do this. Oh, I did not intend to blow myself up with that. This is a Bokoblin camp, apparently. Now we're going to go pick up the Book of Club. First, we're going to try and heal. Now, the Boko Club is a level 12 weapon. Or the spiked Boko Club is a level 12. And thank you. Oh. Okay. So much for the arrows. Okay. So I've got a Zora spear at this point. All we're going to try and do is get the last of this, or this part of the map filled in. So now we're in the rain. That blew up that one. Ah, and hit by the spiked Boko Claw, of course. One more time. We're gonna get to this tower. But at least we have the scale, so that is a good thing. Let's try and use the sickle. That may actually give us a little bit better option. Okay. So that got rid of those. Now we're to the tower. Nope. We're not to the tower. They have made this thing nearly impossible to get to. The lake tower, okay. Because distraction. You overlook a lake. Our goal is merely to get this tower in operation, and then that'll be the end of this episode. There's a point when I use... I'll have to show you how to use bombs to fish. It's actually not that hard, and it actually yields pretty good results. Although... there's a part that reminds me of Klee out of Genshin Impact. That was why she kept ending up in solitary confinement, was she kept blowing up the little blowing up critters. It wasn't just fish, it was rabbits and a whole bunch of other things. But this is the tower. This is Lake Tower at this point, where we're at. Sorry guys, I've been at this for an hour. And that eerie green is one of our pins that we put down. We're gonna distill the map. And with that, that just about ends my live broadcast. So, let's see. We're going to attempt to get okay, there's the Farron Sea. So this is the Farron region. This is the tech lab. That's in Hateno. And there's our horse. I'm not trying to make you all dizzy. I'm trying to figure out. Off this tower. In order to get to the next tower, we'll have to go into the jungle. Not an area I'm really too thrilled to go into, so instead, You know what? Let's try and figure out this is the Farron region. So let's go back this direction to Telonic Shrine. And our next adventure will be trying to get this tower activated, which is the Lanayru Tower. But I want it. Curiosity may kill the cat, but I think it's worth it. I believe there is a tower over in this area. Oh, this is the area I really don't want to go through. Never mind. We'll try that area again a different time. But let's go back to Telonay Shrine. And next week we'll be heading north into the Lanayru region. Now, this is the Farron area, Farron Woods. We'll delete that stamp. But the Farron Grasslands, if you remember the woods we were in Skyward Sword, that's where they are, is this area. This is the Farron Woodlands. And here's the beginning of Farron Woods. And this is where it starts talking about the deep woods. You literally just take a left turn and you're into the deep woods. But with that, I will leave you off. I stream for a group called CDH Stars and Angels. We are a 501c3 nonprofit. That helps children and their families with severe birth defects. Our current fundraiser is, give me a second. A luminary bag event, as well as a pumpkin carving contest and a costume contest. They will be going. Oh, those are both upcoming. What's our current one? We've got a cruise fundraiser. But with that, I will see you. Oh, let's get a picture of this. So that's our rabbit-looking creature. But I will see you on Wednesday with The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, one of our last episodes. So for the CDH Warrior, have a great week.